Yeah, good morning. I shall try to sum up in the next 45 minutes what I kind of heard. This was my first water week as chair of the scientific program committee. I must say that this addressing probably the most important question the world is facing, we, CV, the program committee, would not have been able to do that without the help of FAO and the CGIAR and others from that sector. This whole morning has been about collaboration, about working together. We could not have done this without working closely with the food people. And to the gentleman who asked the question, yes, we should gate crash on your meetings, on the health meetings, and so forth, and we should keep doing that to each other. So I thank you very much, Alexander, and I also thank the CGIAR for making this week a great success by combining the sectors, although I don't think we have a water sector, but yes, communities of water and agriculture. And I'm not going to, I'll drop the 45 minutes, okay? I'll just take one thing. One thing that showed to me why this was important, because I've been to all 20 water weeks, and I'm a water guy type of person. We have been working and working and working up water, efficient irrigation and all of that, and crop per drop, and we have perfected it. And in the end, 30 to 50% is thrown away. So maybe what we should do was go home and look at our fridge and our shopping list and our trash can rather than putting more decimals on our hydrological models. Maybe that's what we should do, the water people. And I think that recognition would not have happened unless we had engaged like we did with you. And I think that also brings me to what I'm going to say about the future. We have all said that the next year is about water cooperation. It's the International Year of Water Cooperation, proposed by Tajikistan to the UN floor. And we embraced it. We, CV, have decided to follow the UN years. Like this year is water and food security. Next year is water and cooperation. 2014 will be water and energy, so you can take notes if you don't know. And 2015, when the MDGs have to be replaced by the SDGs, is naturally water and development. Now, I think that we should look at this as a process and not as a series of events. I don't think this Water Week should say, okay, this was food, thank you very much, FAO, now we do something else. No. I think that we see a progression here from food to cooperation, to energy, to development. The same people and FAO and CGIAR and all you from the food sector are equally important next year and in the energy year and in the development year as you were this year. And I think that I was so happy to hear this morning's closing plenary hammering the message, collaboration, collaboration, collaboration. So next year seems to be very well picked. And we hope to see you back, Alexander, in full speed next year. Now, I'm not going, and we will share with you on the website, so I'm not going to tell you all the details of what next year is going to be about. We have, in the Scientific Program Committee, shared a draft here of how we think we should talk about collaboration next year. And we share that openly. It's a draft. It's not approved by anybody, but yet it will be. You will see it in the first announcement. But basically, what we will do, we will try to bring together the economic sectors, the stakeholder groups, the different management divides. We will try to look at governance, as you asked for. And above all, because this is CV and this is Stockholm Water Week, we will try to help keep bridging that science policy gap that we are all talking about. This is a niche. This is one of the things that is dear to us in Stockholm, that we still have the scientific element, but we also increasingly try to link that with the practitioners and with the policy makers, and of course to World Business Council with the business community, clearly. So I think that we have a very, very promising sequence ahead of us. As you said, Alexander, next year we will also have some good friends. We are talking to Global Water Partnership, to the World Business Council and to WWF, World Food, Worldwide Fund for Nature, on coming to help us next year for this theme. And let me just conclude by saying that I was listening this morning, and we had three very important groups this morning that is also sending us a message about next year. We cannot have a year on water collaboration where the two parts of humanity are not equally represented. So we have to make that happen, and I think we can promise that we will have a strong profile on gender. Now, thank you. That was to the girls and the women, not to me. Now, the other one we heard was from the business community. Pick one word from that, and that was scaling up. And I think that was a very pertinent summary, which then came back here. And I think that's another big challenge. And then finally, what really impressed me, and I raised my hand, who's retired in 10 years? I thought, yeah, who's dead in 10 years? But who's retired in 10 years? And I'm one of them. And these people are the ones, along with my kids and grandkids, who's going to take this forward. It was excellent what they presented to us. And actually, I'm thinking that maybe we should reconsider the title, because they said adaptive idealists. Maybe that should be the title of next year. We will see what it will be, but I thank you so much to the youth. This gives a lot of room for optimism when we can see the youth coming in this way. So next year, let's meet here. Please think about what you can do, and think now. Don't wait too long, what you can do to come here and be adaptive idealist next year. Thank you very much.